Trade and Jobs Advisor, Curtis Ellis. It's great to have you both here. I'll have to interrupt you. My apologies in advance when that briefing begins. But Liz, I want to pick up on something that Blake just reported, and that was those comments from President Trump yesterday about China. The idea of tariffs is basically punishment, and I'm paraphrasing. What do you make of that?
Well, I totally agree that we have to punish China for not being straightforward about this horrible virus that has caused so many deaths and so much destruction. But I don't think tariffs is the way to go, Cheryl. We've used tariffs to reset our trade agreement. That was a good idea. But this is very different. I think this calls upon us to actually work very hard to bring supply chains in to the United States, make sure we are never again dependent on China for medicines, medical supplies. I would expand that to other important, sensitive products that are high tech and things like that. We need to show the world that China is not trustworthy. That's what the message is here. Tariffs isn't the way to go. I think other measures, being very cautious about letting scientists and Chinese students into our universities, being very, very careful about what kinds of companies China can acquire in the United States, all those send a message of distrust. And that's what we should be showing here. I think there are other ways to do it. And by the way, I totally agree, not repaying debt would be the opposite. That would show us to be untrustworthy, not China.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and to be fair, that is debt that we as a nation took on. But at the same time, yeah. Curtis, I want to bring in Curtis because, you know, obviously, you know, the supply chain from China has come into question. And we knew we were over-dependent on the Chinese, whether it was for prescription drugs or for goods, for services. But this really makes it very clear that we can't trust them. What do we do as a nation?
I agree with Liz. We have to bring the supply chains back to the United States. We saw an executive order today where the president signed an order saying that power utility companies cannot be buying goods from China for the power stations and for transmission lines. Right now, there is one U.S. manufacturer of the electrical grade steel that go into these high voltage transformers that are a crucial part of our electrical grid. We cannot be dependent on China for that, for things like that, but that's the case right now. One way we get these supply chains back to the United States is by using tariffs. That's how we built our industry in the first place. There was a barrier of tariffs that made it uneconomical to import manufactured goods from overseas, made it more economical to manufacture those goods in the United States. That's how we built this country. That was the American system. The other thing we're hearing sources say that the president is getting ready to block the Thrift Savings Plan, the federal retirement funds, from being invested in Chinese companies. That's another way we can cut off the blood supply to the Chinese Communist Party. We don't have to sue them and try to get them to pay money. We just don't give them money in the first place. That's a much more efficient way to make them pay.
Yeah, and Liz, I mean, you know, think of all of the Chinese companies that are publicly listed on the NASDAQ, for example. And, you know, these are companies that don't have the same standards, frankly, that U.S. companies do, and though they say that they do. But I do want to ask you, Liz, real quick about Larry Kudlow and those comments he made this morning about it being weeks before we talk about more stimulus. I mean, that's a lot. We have a country that is suffering. You got 30 million people filing for initial jobless claims in 6 weeks. Can we wait 4 weeks, 5 weeks, Liz?
Well, I think we can. And I think at this point, it's pretty obvious that an awful lot of the money that is supposed to be going out to people in distress and businesses in distress hasn't gotten out there yet, Cheryl. So let's wait and see. There are some indications already that this economy is bouncing off the bottom, a little bit of a sign that retailers are seeing business pick up. An awful lot of states have begun to reopen. I think it would be incredibly careless to just, I mean, Nancy Pelosi is talking about another $1 trillion. People have to take a step back and say, okay, what have we done to the Fed's balance sheet? What are we doing to our national debt? I know that these issues are not being talked about very aggressively right now. I get it. The nation is suffering. But let's see what kind of green shoots show up and what kind of natural recovery we're going to have before we ladle on another $1 trillion in debt.
Yeah. Well, Liz and Curtis, I appreciate your time. And certainly there's a lot to cover, and we'll have you back both very soon on this program. Again, we are waiting for the White House press briefing to begin in Washington. Those China trade worries, though, and the president brought this up yesterday, coupled with disappointing earnings, sending stocks well into the red for the first day of trading for the month of May. But I got to remind